Hello, this is Rick Ridings coming to you with another prayer update from Jerusalem. It's January 19th, and this is day 105 of the war with Hamas. I'm going to share today what I believe may be a very key strategic way to pray in the media and warfare that is going on surrounding this war. As you know, what is going forth in the nations is so important at this time. We've been praying, of course, concerning the International Court of Justice, that in the mercy of the Lord for the nations, because nations are in the valley of decision, we're praying that the nations may not politicize this decision, that the judges from the nations would not politicize their decision, but that there would be a turning to the plumb line of God's truth and God's justice. And in this whole war that is going on in the media, there's a very key scripture that I believe we need to proclaim over Israel, and then I'll share how I believe the indigenous peoples have a very great role in fulfilling this scripture. It says in Isaiah 54, verse 17, "No weapon forged against you will prevail, and you will refute every tongue that accuses you. This is the heritage of the servants of the Lord, and this is their vindication from me, declares the Lord." So God is saying there to Israel, the context is to Israel. He's saying there'll be a lot of accusation brought against them. But he says, I myself will refute those tongues that accuse you. This is your heritage. And so we're believing the Lord to raise up voices that will prevail, and that the lies and the weapons that are formed against Israel at this time, that they cannot defend themselves against a terrorist entity, Hamas, that is so over and over declared and continues to declare that its goal is not finished unless it destroys Israel, basically destroying the Jewish people and destroying Israel. And in this battle for information, in the battle for truth in the media, God is doing something very special here right now that I'd like to ask you to pray for. One of the lies that has been presented by terror groups such as Hamas and their voice piece in the Hague South African government, the ANC government, is that Israel is just a modern Israel is a state of colonizers who have come to take over and occupy and oppress the indigenous people, and the Palestinians have presented themselves as the indigenous people of the land. But that is absolutely not true. Most of those who call themselves Palestinian are more recent immigrants into this area who came from other parts of like Syria and Iraq and Arabia, Saudi Arabia and this. Even those that go back only go back usually a few hundred years. And it's important that the Jewish presence in this land has been continual. At times it was very small because of exiles, but there was always a continued Jewish presence in this land for over 3,200 years. And so they, by all the criteria by which they judge indigenous, there are seven criteria given by a major anthropologist that is respected worldwide. Based on that kind of criteria, the United Nations has given seven criteria. Out of those seven criteria to determine who are an indigenous people in a land, six of them apply to the Jewish people, and perhaps only one could be used by those that call themselves Palestinians. Now, again, we're not against the Palestinian people. We love the people and we pray for their salvation. But we are against demonic lies and demonic powers that would try to destroy God's promise to the Jewish people that he would bring them back from exile to once again develop their land, which they are doing. It's very interesting in terms of South Africa's ANC party being the one that brought these charges in The Hague. They, according to reports, very credible reports, were on the verge of bankruptcy as a party, and this was going to cause great problems for them. And then they had visits from leaders of Hamas and leaders from Iran. And immediately after that, they announced that they were able to pay off their debts. And then they announced that they were going to come against Israel with a charge of genocide in the International Court of Justice. So it's very obvious that what has come forth there finds its root once again in the evil regime in Iran. Now, God is raising up voices of truth. And one of those major voices of truth is God is raising up people who are native peoples, indigenous peoples all over the world. God is raising up them to be a voice to say, we recognize that by the criteria for indigenous peoples, the Jews are the indigenous people of this land. So recently, for example, the regent, which is another word for king, of the Khoi people, one of the oldest tribes in the whole world, all across Southern Africa, Regent Wayne Tsiami made a statement about the ANC, the ruling party of South Africa. He said that the Khoi kingdom of Southern Africa distances itself from the case against Israel. We believe the accusation of genocide against Israel is ill-advised, one-sided, and does not reflect the reality of the situation. Now, we've been praying that people like Regent Wayne could be given more of a platform, and God has opened some doors where we're working together with the deputy mayor of Jerusalem, Fleur Hassan Nahum, who is a very dedicated civil servant as the deputy mayor and who understands the importance of this kind of truth being given a platform. And so we're working together with her, along with others, especially the Indigenous Coalition for Israel, to inaugurate on February 1st an Indigenous Embassy Jerusalem that will be a platform for voices such as Regent Wayne to speak truth. He's actually coming with two of his major chiefs and going to be part of this very small gathering because it had to move quickly in order to happen at this key moment in the war with the case that's been presented at the Hague. And so these are coming, and I'd like to ask you to pray that God will protect. There's a lot of spiritual warfare around this. There are some wonderful major indigenous leaders who are coming from the Pacific region, these from Africa. There's at least one or two that will be representing indigenous peoples from North America, Canada, and pray protection over this, and pray that God will keep it pure. Pray that it will become a voice for truth in this warfare, which is also part of the warfare of Israel right now, in the media, worldwide. God will take care of Israel. It's his word. It's his promise. God will also deal with the terrorists like Hamas and Hezbollah, the Houthis and the Iranian regime. God will deal with them as he's made very clear in Psalm 83 that we have shared on these prayer alerts before. But right now, the nations are being put in the balance in the valley of decision. So Father, from Jerusalem, we pray that modern nation states and ancient peoples, as your word in the Bible for nation is more the idea of a people, we pray that indigenous peoples, First Nations, all over the world, that believers among them who see the lies that have been presented will be able to come here to Jerusalem, will be able to have a platform to give forth a voice for truth into the nations. We pray, O God, that you will keep hidden that which needs to be hidden. We pray the power of the blood of Jesus, the blood of Yeshua over everyone who will be coming, not only for this inauguration, but for later larger events. And we pray that they will be given media platforms where they can speak forth your truth. And once again, we proclaim your word from Isaiah 54, verse 17, over Israel. No weapon formed against you will prevail. You will refute every tongue that accuses you. This is the heritage of the servants of the Lord, and this is their vindication from me, declares the Lord. Shalom from Jerusalem. Shabbat shalom.